What's up, guys? Larry Chen here. We are at Grid Life South 2019 at Road Atlanta. These guys actually make custom car pins. So I made one for my Corolla camera car as well as my 240Z. Just wanted to pick his brain and talk to him about the whole culture behind it.
Yo, what's going on? My name's Hansel. I own and operate Leen Customs. So I'm based out of LA, California.
Anytime I meet someone new, I kind of want to give them one of my pins. And relating this to Hot Wheels, especially with what they've been doing recently with these famous cars and yes, tuner cars and cars that we only aspire to own one day, these pins kind of have that same aura, same feeling, which, by the way, we definitely have to do a walk around on your really awesome little van here. It's not even a short bus, it's like the shortest bus. Yeah.
Taking on the whole thing with Hot Wheels is presentation. They're all symmetrical, they're all facing the same way. I wanted to kind of do the same thing when it came to presenting my pin. That's Leen Custom.
You're building these pins to the point where they're so cool and they're so detailed that you don't even want to use them. I have hundreds of Hot Wheels, but I don't open any of them. The artwork and then the presentation of it is so important to me. You kind of do the same thing with these, perfect presentation in terms of a gift. It's not just the pin.
For me, my background is graphic design. But when it came to doing car pins, I realized that there wasn't anything really catered to car enthusiasts as far as a mixture of art and pin. That's kind of what I decided to create. It basically went from one pin design. I actually did a Subaru because it's my favorite car. And I was like, oh, you know, see if people like it. The response was so great. A buddy was like, oh, why don't you make people's cars? Like, do offer customs. If I personally thought it was a little weird, but it isn't, man. People love it. With social media now, like, there's just a huge fan base with people and builders and, you know, brands. So it's just a nice piece of collectible that you can definitely own, even though it's not yours, you know, and appreciate.
When you want to talk about detail, the camera car, it has the arm, right? The arm moves. Their mind is blown from that. Look closer. Look at the lens. There is a red stripe. Canon L lens stripe on the pin. It's so detailed. Yeah. How is that even possible?
I think because I'm the graphic artist, like, I know exactly the amount of detail I'm able to do, from the smallest color fill-in to the type of metal that I'm going to be using for the cutout. It all varies. You know, people think, oh, it's just a pin, but like, the metal in each pin is sometimes different depending on how much detail I want to put in.
My experience from pin collecting just comes from Disneyland. People spend thousands of dollars on Disney pins.
Man,
like, it is people's lives to collect those pins and go to Disneyland and Disney World and trade them. It's just crazy. So it's kind of cool that you're using a little bit of that fandom for cars. What's cool about your pins, they're not actually true to form with the car. They're a little bit cartoonish, and that's kind of cool. Let's go over some of the favorite ones that you have. Ryan Turk's car, Ora Swang, Kyle Mohan, Matt Kaufman. There's just so many iconic cars, like the Jurassic Park cars, which I love that one comes upside down and smashed from the T-Rex. The Mystery Machine, there's just so many awesome cars here. Oh, you got the Millennium Falcon?
Yeah, so that's a cool one because you don't really see it as a side profile shot. Yeah. You know, everything's always from the top view. Keeping to my style, I wanted to create it as a side profile.
And I love that for the drift cars. Since the side profile, you have them doing counter steering. So what are some of your favorite pins that may not be here?
That's a really common question. Model A from Stanceware. It was just one of the pins that I had fun designing. You know, it was probably one of my top 10 that I've done so far.
This is your full-time job then?
Yeah, so I actually quit my job last year in July. The amount of support I've gotten from everyone that's buying, you know, reposting, ordering custom work, you know, has helped me, you know, make this my full-time gig.
Let's talk about the car a little bit. It looks like a pin already. You didn't actually have to make it any more cartoonish than it was.
Exactly, yeah.
What is this thing?
So it's a 1990 Daihatsu Miura walkthrough van. I got it imported from Japan with the help of my buddies over at Houston, Shinku Classic. And I started looking into doing like a mobile pop-up shop. I wanted to create something that was different. So I started just kind of researching, right? And with that, I found this, the Daihatsu Miura. With the help of some of the people that I've worked with in the past, we were able to kind of get it to this final form or where it's at, with like air suspension, wheels. Icebox Customs, he helped me with putting it together. Trunk setup, I custom made like struts for the front. Found some local wheels on eBay and some Hayashi Racing. Got them restored and everything. And
thanks for showing us your ride and also your pins.
Yeah.
Oh, that is so cool. Dude, right-hand drive? Oh, that's the air system right there.